Hi, welcome back to Calm Your Dog. I'm Barbara and this is Sponge, and today we're going to be looking at, can any dog breed be a service dog? First though, I'd love to know what you think. Is your dog a service dog? Do you think that any dog breed can be a service dog? Are there breeds of dogs that definitely should not be service dogs? Just pop it in the comments below after you've watched this video. We would love to hear what you think. The short answer is technically any dog can be a service dog, but that does not mean that all breeds should be service dogs. If your dog can detect blood sugar levels for someone who has diabetes, detect a seizure for someone with epilepsy, help someone get around who is blind, etc., then on paper, it doesn't matter what breed that dog is. But if you have a dog with a reputation for being an aggressive or a protective breed, your dog may not be accepted everywhere as a service dog, and we'll address that controversy in a minute. So what are the qualities of a top service dog? The top qualities are high intelligence and also temperaments that make them easy to train. These dogs need to remain attentive and focused on their owner's needs without getting distracted by crowds of people, traffic, other smells, etc. This is why many service dogs are Labradors, Retrievers, or German Shepherds. Here are some surprising breeds that are very good service dogs that you might not have thought of. Starting with poodles. Poodles have excellent noses for detecting allergens. Then there are Bernese Mountain Dogs, who can support the weight of an adult who needs help getting up, and they can even pull a wheelchair out of a tough spot. Then there are Great Danes with their massive size. They can help the mobility impaired, for example. Collies are very, very good at detecting impending seizures for people. And last but not least, Pomeranians. These tiny dogs are excellent for alerting their owners to symptoms or problems with diabetes, asthma, and Parkinson's disease, and they can help the hearing impaired as well. Next, there are what are called fake service dogs. Some breeds aren't accepted by everyone as service dogs because of their reputation for being highly aggressive or territorial. And yet, some people insist on calling these dogs service dogs, not because they really are service dogs, but because they want to act as a breed advocate. This is where it gets controversial. There are people buying fake service dog vests and putting them on their untrained dogs, and then the dogs are getting into trouble when they're put in a situation they haven't been trained for. Let's look at what are known as bully breeds. Some dogs are known as bully breeds because they're safe for their owners, whom they've bonded with, but not for the general public. These dogs, while they are technically intelligent enough to perform the tasks required to support and help people, these dogs are naturally protective who are not always good around strangers. Example breeds are American Staffordshire Terriers, American Bulldogs, and Bull Mastiffs. One well-known pit bull breeder says she won't allow people to adopt her dogs if they want to make them service dogs because, she says, it isn't fair to the dog to put him in a situation where his protective nature can work against him. So, what do you think about dog breeds who can be service dogs? Do you think that any dog breed should be allowed to do it? What do you think about some of the breeds that are extra protective or that have a more aggressive temperament? Just pop it in the comments below. We would love to hear what you think. And if you've enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It helps the channel a lot. And if you haven't yet subscribed, you can do that by clicking on the button in the middle there. And while you're there, you can hop on over to the far right and check out one of our previous vlog videos. Thank you so much for watching, and Sponge and I will see you again very soon. Bye for now.